Welcome to the chainsaw workshop. Sometimes after doing service or using your product, you will notice that a chain might start crawling forward or move on idling speed. When the chain brake is disengaged and it's on idling speed, that the chain slightly moves forward like this. Before making any adjustments to the carburetor, just make sure that all the technical parts are okay or in place. That means correct chain tension, that the clutch is not broken, or at least the springs from the clutch, that the air filter and the fuel filter are clean, that the gas tanks, oil and fuel are filled up till the top, that the maintenance is done properly, that there are no broken parts. If that's okay and the chain is still moving or crawling forward, there is one thing you can do, that's adjusting here the T-screw from the carburetor, and the T stands for throttle adjustment screw. So this is where we adjust the idling speed. If you don't have any screws or holes to access the carburetor, that means that's an electronic carburetor, so you need to go to see your dealer or somebody who has the software to reset and to update it. But in this case, you can just adjust the T-screw. The L and the H needle is for the engine adjustment. So if you don't have the correct tools and the tables to adjust according the manufacturer's details, just let it over to a professional, to a specialist, and just do whatever you can. In this case, we're going to run the chainsaw. You will see the revolutions over here. The chain starts moving or crawling forward, and as you can see, the RPMs are pretty high up. So in this case, for this machine, this is the CS621SX, the idling speed should be adjusted on 2800. Screw counterclockwise, so you lower the idling speed or the RPMs on idling speed. If your engine shuts off on idling speed, that means that the idling speed is maybe too low, or there are other facts that will influence this idling speed. Same thing, make sure that the clutch drum is not broken and the clutch springs, that the chain tension is properly adjusted, that the fuel tank is full, that the fuel filter and air filter is clean, right spark plug, and so on. And then you can do the opposite way. So you move the T-screw clockwise to increase the RPMs. So if you do that, you will increase. Might be that you need to go a couple of turns before you reach an acceptable idling speed, but make sure that the chain doesn't start running on idling speed and that the machine doesn't shut off on idling speed.